new details are now emerging about the U.S. military's hypersonic missiles endeavor. Long-Range Hypersonic Weapon, or LRHW, which is a land-based concept for U.S. Army, has been depicted in a PowerPoint slide at a recent defense conference. The slide was shown at the 22nd Space and Missile Defense Symposium, which was held in Huntsville, Alabama earlier this month, and the disclosure came from Army Rapid Capabilities and Critical Technologies Office, RCCTO. Hypersonic weapons development is a relatively new area and has seen considerable interest in recent times from some countries. LRHW is one of the several hypersonic weapons development programs being undertaken by the U.S. military. Reports suggest the Army is aiming to deploy the first experimental LRWH battery in 2023. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes long-range hypersonic weapon, LRHW, of U.S. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. An object is said to be hypersonic once they exceed speeds of Mach 5. That's 5 times the speed of sound. This is about 1,715 meters per second, or 3,836 miles per hour, or 6,174 kilometers per hour. There are currently 2 methods being applied to make hypersonic weapons. First is using a scramjet engine. The scramjet is an innovation on the ramjet. Ramjet engine can power flight to supersonic speeds, but scramjet can enable the missiles to reach hypersonic speeds. These engines have no moving parts, like the compressors and turbines used in the turbofan engines found on conventional jet planes. They rely on the huge pressures created by fast airflow into the engine to ignite the fuel and generate thrust. In this method, a rocket booster is used to accelerate the missile to hypersonic speed. Then the scramjet engine kicks in and enables the missile to fly at sustained hypersonic speed. Second is using hypersonic glide vehicle, HGV. In this method, the system is launched to extremely high altitudes using ballistic missile or an aircraft, where it skips across the Earth's upper atmosphere. The vehicle then separates from the carrier, and the scramjet engine takes over, accelerating it to hypersonic speeds as it glides back to Earth towards the intended target. LRHW will be using hypersonic glide vehicle methodology. The slide gives an overall description of LRHW. It consists of a prototype ballistic missile, an all-up round, or AUR. As portrayed, the missile is encased in a canister. The missile has a diameter of 34.5 inches. To give viewers a perspective, a Tomahawk cruise missile has a diameter of about 20 inches. The missile has common hypersonic glide body, CHGB, placed on top of it. It's developed by Sandia National Laboratory, and the CHGB will be used by the Army, Navy, and Air Force. Viewers may note that the CHGB is probably based on the Army Hypersonic Weapon, or AHW. A boost glide vehicle, the AHW, was tested in 2011 and achieved a speed of Mach 8 and a range of almost 4,000 miles, or 6,437 kilometers. The TELs are the modified M983A4 Heavy Expanded Mobility Tactical Trucks, HEMTT. M983A4 is currently being used in Patriot Anti-Aircraft Missile System, An M870 trailer is also shown, which will be used to move the TOW. AFTDS, or Advanced Field Artillery Tactical Data System, version 7, will be present for battle management duties. The slide shows four transporter erector launchers, TELs, each with two missile carriers. Countries like Russia, China, Israel, India, and the US have been developing sophisticated layered air defense. These systems are difficult for traditional aircraft and missiles to penetrate. For example, Russia has deployed S-400 air defense system. S-400 Triumph is an anti-aircraft weapon system developed by Russia's Almaz Central Design Bureau in the 1990s as an upgrade of the S-300 family. It's been in service with the Russian Armed Forces since 2007. It's designed to defend against aircraft, including fifth-generation stealth fighters, bombers, AWACS, cruise missiles, and even ballistic missiles. S-400 can track hundreds of targets at a time, engage up to 36 targets in parallel, and simultaneously launch 72 missiles. Russia is also working on S-500, which will be even more potent. US fields several systems that are designed to intercept ballistic as well as cruise missiles, like THAAD, or Terminal High Altitude Area Defense, which is designed to shoot down short, medium, and intermediate range ballistic missiles in the terminal phase. US Navy also has a large number of Ticonderoga class and Arleigh Burke class warships, which have the Aegis combat system. Aegis ballistic missile defense, which is part of the Aegis combat system, is devised to intercept ballistic missiles post-boost phase and before re-entry. It uses standard missile like SM-3 and SM-6 to shoot down incoming threats. On the surface, missile defense looks like a defensive weaponry, but it can disturb the MAD equilibrium. Mutually Assured Destruction, MAD, is a doctrine of military strategy and national security policy, in which a full-scale use of nuclear weapons by two or more opposing sides would cause the complete annihilation of both the attacker and the defender. It's based on the theory of deterrence, which holds that the threat of using strong weapons against the enemy prevents the enemy's use of those same weapons. This balance will be disturbed if any country is able to field a fully functional missile defense system that can defend against the enemy's missile. It's to be noted that traditional ballistic missiles also reach hypersonic speed when they descend on the target, but they follow a predictable, predefined parabolic path, which could lead to possible interception by anti-ballistic missile defense systems. This is where hypersonic weapons come in. Their extreme speed and ability to fly in unpredictable paths give them a high probability of penetrating the air defenses. Weapons of this type follow a very different flight trajectory within the atmosphere and can make rapid course changes. They'll be very hard to track, and current air defense systems have almost no chance in intercepting them. The characteristic of hypersonic weapons make it suitable for neutralizing well-defended strategic military assets. These weapons may also be used in neutralizing incoming enemy missiles, where they'll be used as interceptors. Hypersonic weapons are currently being pursued mainly by America, Russia, and China. Russia is at the forefront of hypersonic weapons. It's reached an advanced level with two hypersonic weapons, Kinzhal and Avangard. The Kinzhal, or Dagger, was one of the weapons the Russian President Vladimir Putin unveiled in his State of the Nation address last year. Kinzhal is a scramjet-powered hypersonic cruise missile. It reportedly has a range of approximately 1,250 miles or 2,000 kilometers and a top speed of Mach 10. According to the Russian President, units in the country's southern military district, which borders Ukraine and the Black Sea, have deployed the missiles operationally. Avangard was also unveiled by Mr. Putin during the same address. It's a nuclear hypersonic boost glide vehicle he said would go on the future RS-26 Rubezh ICBM. Putin said Avangard could reach speeds of up to 20 times the speed of sound, hitting its targets like a meteorite, like a fireball. China is developing its own hypersonic weapons, and it's thought to be pursuing a hypersonic cruise missile as well as a hypersonic boost glide vehicle. For some time, the American military has been undecided when it comes to developing and deploying hypersonic weapons. This led to US military lagging in this technology. But things have changed in recent time, and the US is now moving with full throttle. As per reports, US military is pursuing 9 programs that are dedicated to fielding hypersonic weapons. Not only this, but US military is also looking ahead and studying the feasibility of developing an air defense system that can engage hypersonic weapons. Hypersonic weapons will play a key part in future battles, and it remains to be seen who gets the edge.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.